Hey, what's up? I got an email this morning from a viewer, and I can't pronounce the viewer's name. There's way too many consonants, not enough syllables in this name. But they're having a problem with their mixing. Here's the problem. It's not matching the beats. They can match beats just fine. Their problem is the people who are listening to their mixes are finding them boring. And I think a lot of DJs fall into this trick bag sometimes. Just because the beats match together doesn't mean that it's interesting. And when you're first learning how to mix, who cares? Any two songs that beat mix together, do it. But once you start playing for crowds, you really need to make these mixes interesting. Now, I'm not a great mixer. I never will be. I never have been. But I'm going to try to take two songs today and make them a little more interesting by mixing them in the right place at the right time. So for what it's worth, check it out. We're going to use the SDJ2 by American DJ today for this. Our first example today is Till You Come Back by, I guess it's a Norfatini featuring Peyton. It's a 12-inch mix of this track, and you'll find a lot of times with these 12-inch mixes you'll have very long intros and very long outros. Well, these are really designed for DJs to mix or remix. Right here, there's not a lot going on. It's funky. It's a nice beat. But there's not a lot happening aside from the beat. There's going to be a change tone up here in just a second. Check it out. The kick came in. Okay, there's our first sample. Second sample is Some Kind of Rush by Booty Love. I really like this track. This is the 12-inch version, but the intro is missing something. And the intro is really supposed to be missing something. Again, these are designed for DJs to mix and remix. Now you see, on this track, what we have is melody. Where on this track, we've got a groove. We got our beat. So why not put these two tracks together and do something interesting with them? Now, it's not enough just to mix them together haphazardly. It's probably a good idea to know when you're mixing them in and why you're doing it, basically. So let's start off with Till You Come Back. I'm going to give it an 8 count, and then I'm going to bring in Some Kind of Rush. And then I'm going to do a loop. You'll see here. Check it out. 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4. Now remember when we had the kick drum come in here Until You Come Back? Listen to what happens over here on Some Kind of Rush. Here it comes. Now I like that kick drum, I'm going to keep it, so I'm going to loop this. Hopefully I get the loop right. So I've taken this cool beat that I like, and this cool melody I like, and I've put them together as one. So essentially, remixing. But I knew exactly what I wanted to do. I didn't just throw them together. I knew when I wanted to bring them in and why I wanted to bring them in there. I'm gonna know when I wanna take it out too. I'm gonna take out Till You Come Back. As soon as Some Kind of Rush finally kicks in. Or I can leave it. First I'll take it out, then I'll bring it back in. Ready, take it out, here we go. Now I can put it back in. We'll be right back.
doesn't sound a lot different at that point.
So there was my attempt at an example of how to maybe take two tracks and make them work well together. Now, I don't know how well they work together. I don't know if I would have moved a crowd with that, but I did put some thought into that mix. I knew exactly when I wanted to bring in the second track, I knew when I wanted the loop, and I knew what was going to happen. I knew when the kick drum was going to come in on one track and what was going to happen on the other track simultaneously. So I felt like it made it a little more interesting. And when you're working with house or trance or drum and bass or something like that, it can get quite repetitive. And regardless as to what anyone tells you, people do still like melody. So when you get boom, 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 that's all well and good, but you need to put something else in there, because otherwise, all night long would just sound like boom, 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 boom. And many times it does. I know a lot of you have gone to places before. I know I have. I've gone, you know, to turntableless bars or whatever, gotten really excited. Ooh, I'm going to see something cool tonight. And all night long, boom, 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 boom. And I'm bored out of my mind, because you can only listen to that for so long. But anyway, there's my attempt. I hope it helped someone out there. Practice and enjoy.